Hello friends, in this video I am telling the receiving how to draw the receiving end circle diagram. This is a very common question that are asking in the inter university exams. So I am telling one simple example of that depend on the receiving end circle diagram. So let's start. A 50 hertz three phase 275 kilohertz 400 kilometer means this is a long transmission line. So we have to use for that the transmission line has the following parameters RLC. So R is equal to 0.035 ohm per kilometer per phase, and inductance is 1.1 millihenry per kilometer per phase, and capacitance is 0.12 microfarad per kilometer per phase. And in the line, if the line is supported at 275 kilovolt, determine the MVA rating of the shunt reactor having the negligible losses that will be required to maintain 275. Means to maintain to 275 kilovolt means the receiving end voltage also 275 and sending end voltage also 275 kilovolt at the receiving end. And when the line is delivered no load, use nominal pi method. Here we have to use nominal pi method. So we have given the length is 400 kilometer means the long transmission line. We have RLC and we have to convert in the per phase. So we have to multiply the length of the transmission line. So we have 40 kilometer per phase and 0.44 henry per phase and 4.8 × 10⁻⁶ farad per phase. Thus we have the expression of the complex power received and received at the end power is SR is equal to minus mod of A by B in mod of VR receiving end voltage square into angle of beta minus alpha plus VS VR upon beta into angle of beta minus del. Now we have to use nominal pi method, so we know that for that and the long transmission line we have the formula, that is VS ABCD parameter VS IS this ABCD and VR IR. So we have A is equal to D. So we have A is equal to D is equal to this 1 plus 1 by 2 YZ and B is equal to Z. So now we have to calculate the center of the receiving end circle diagram. So we have the formula, that is center 1 plus 1 mod of A by B into VR square at an angle of beta minus alpha with the negative megawatt. So we have the receiving end circle diagram, and well also the radius of the circle diagram is Vs Vr upon B, and that is we already know that Vs sending end voltage is 275 and receiving end voltage is already the same, that is 275 kilovolt. Now we have A is equal to this is the formula A, and B is equal to Z is equal to R plus Jx. So we have to calculate X. So X is equal to this is X 2 pi FL 2 pi F is equal to 50 hertz frequency, and L we have already calculated, that is L we have already calculated, that is 0.44. So X is equal to we have calculated 138.23 ohm. Now so we have calculated Z is equal to R plus Jx. So we have R 14 plus jx this is, and so we have this so we have to calculate in a rectangular form 138.98 at an angle 84.16 ohm. So now we have to calculate Y, that is admittance j omega c is equal to 2 pi fc 2 pi f and c, frequency and c we already calculated as x. So J is equal to 1.5 × 10⁻³. So Y is equal to in the rectangular form this now we have to calculate A parameter and B parameter. So A parameter we have already the formula, that is A is equal to 1 plus 1 by 2 YZ. So putting the value of Y and Z in the rectangular form, we got A is equal to in the polar, A is equal to this, and in the we have converted this in the rectangular form, we got 0.8963 at an angle 0.67 degree. So now we have to calculate the center of the circle. We already discussed the formula, that is center of the circle by formula A mod of A by B into VR square at an angle beta minus alpha. So we have A by B. A we already calculate 0.8963 and VR 275 at an angle to 75 VR square means multiply by 2 again, and upon B, 138.93. Again, we have to hear mod, so we have to only take the magnitude of the given parameters. So we have calculated the center of the circle, that is 487.89 MVA. Because this is in KV, this is a KV, so we have in MVA. Now the radius of the circle is formula, we know that VR upon B in so we have 275 same voltage, and B is equal to already calculate B is equal to Z. So we have calculated the radius of the circle in MVA. Again, here in KV, so this is in MV. So now at an angle beta, the center of the circle we have to calculate at we have to draw at an angle beta minus alpha. Here the beta is the angle of A, and beta is the angle of B, and alpha is the angle of A. Of the transmission line parameters, so we have to draw it on the graph paper. So I have already draw the x-axis and y-axis. Here on x-axis we have to plot the MV, megawatt, and on the y-axis MVA, and also I have taken the scale of 1 centimeter is equal to 10 MVA. So 100 MVA. So we have to calculate, we have to draw the center of the receiving end circle diagram on the axis. So we have the angle, that is beta minus alpha, that is 83.5. this angle we have to consider at the negative axis of the megawatts. So we have the protector, that's we have to measure the angle with this axis, that is 83.5. I'm right, yes, 83.5. so we have taken the angle, that is 83.5. here the scale is somewhat missing, so you adjust this. I have already calculated this 83.5, so this is angle of 83.5. now we have to take the center of the circle diagram, that is 487.89 MVA. This is in MVA. Now we have scale, 1 centimeter is equal to 100 MVA. So we have to convert in the centimeter. So we have divide 487.89 divided by 100. That's why I got 4.87. So we have to take the distance from the center and at angle beta minus alpha, 4.87. so we have 4.87. this is center of the circle, 1.47. so now we have to join this distance. Now this is 1.47, 4.87 centimeter. So this is the center of the circle we are getting. Now we have to draw this circle diagram. So we have that also, we want the radius. So we have already calculated the radius, that is 544.33 MVA. This is also in MVA. So we have to convert in the centimeter. So 544.33 upon 100. So we have 5.44. So we have to take the distance in the chalk, that is 5.44. so 5.44, this is already I have said this at the 5.4. So we have take the distance from the center of the circle, and we have to draw the circle. So I have draw the circle, semicircle. So this is passed through this line. So we have given, so we have to, what we have to calculate, we have to calculate the, determine the MVA rating of the shunt cap reactor, have shunt reactor. So MVA rating, we have to determine the MVA rating. So we have given this, we have obtained this MVA rating, and this is angle beta minus alpha is equal to 83.5 degree, and this is MVA rating. MVA rating is equal to, we have to calculate this by the scale. So we have 5 and 6. We have here given a 6. So we have taken 55. 55 MVA. So the answer is rating of shunt reactor is 55 MVA. And thank you for the watching this video, and if you like this video, you can share and like hit a bell icon.